Medical students learn about 15,000 new words over the course of their 4 years of medical training. That's about 4,000 new words per year. Well, how do we learn and remember all of these new words and things that we're being taught? In this video today, I'm going to be talking about how I memorized everything in college, medical school, residency, as well as even fellowship. What's up everyone, this is Dr. Webb here. Thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure you subscribe. New videos coming every week. You don't want to miss them. So, how did I memorize everything in college, medical school, residency, and now in fellowship? Well, we learned in medical school that the brain is like a hard drive. It processes information and stores this information for later use. There's a portion of the brain called the hippocampus that is responsible for processing this information and storage of memory. And this storage is limited. This protects you from information overload by getting rid of irrelevant information and then storing the more important things that you need to remember. Researchers have found that there are three main stages of memory processing. There's encoding, there's storage, and there's information retrieval. Encoding is the way that we get the information into our brain and how we process that information. And there are three main ways to do that. There's acoustic, which is sound. There's visual, which is looking at like a picture, and there's semantics, which is understanding and meaning. Evidence suggests that the principal coding system in short-term memory is acoustic coding. When a person is presented a list of numbers or letters, they will generally try to hold this into their short-term memory by verbalizing those numbers or letters. Say for instance, you were trying to remember a phone number. So you got the number 972-308. Then you repeat this information, 972-308. You're repeating this information, this number, so that you can store that into your short-term memory bank. The principal encoding system in long-term memory is semantic or meaning. This is evidenced by the fact that if you understand something, you'll remember it longer. In medical school, I utilize all three ways of encoding information. The visual, the acoustic, as well as the semantics. For visual encoding, I used to look at diagrams, different pictures, different textbooks, and looked at different formats of that particular concept so that I can understand it better. Acoustically, I would listen to lecture audios and I would listen to them on repeat. At my medical school at Georgetown, there was a recording system that would record all the lecture audios. And on the way to the gym or running some errands or going between hospitals, I would listen to those lecture audios to try to get that information into my short-term memory. If your school doesn't have a recording system, I suggest that you record the lectures on your phone. This will give you the lecture audio at your fingertips, and you can listen to these lecture audios when you're around the house doing chores, you're running errands, or if you're at the gym exercising. The principal encoding system in long-term memory is semantic coding. This is evidenced by the fact that if you understand something, the longer that you will remember that particular concept. In medical school, before the exam came up, I would make sure that I understood the material. The way I did this was I would teach one of my colleagues or classmates a particular concept. Say for instance, we were learning about the mechanism of action of warfarin. To make sure that I understood the mechanism of action, I would teach this to my classmate. Or sometimes what we would do is get a large whiteboard and then write out the entire mechanism of action. And I've always been taught that if you can teach someone something, then you understand it well enough. The second stage of memory involves storage. This deals with what type of information that we store, where we store it, and also how long we store this information for. Information can be stored for a brief duration in short-term memory, such as seconds, but information in long-term memory can be stored for a lifetime. In this stage, I suggest that you think of a big picture first and then get the small details later. In medical school, when I was approaching a particular concept, I would try to get a big picture of that concept, and as time went on, I would try to learn more of those details of that particular concept. The last stage of memory is retrieval. In medical school, I had a system in place where I previewed, I went to lecture, and then I reviewed. Usually the night before a lecture, I would go through the syllabus and make sure that I knew what the lecturer was going to be talking about the next day. Then in lecture, I would actively listen. Previewing the night before allowed me to actively listen during this lecture, and I gained a lot of more information and took a lot more out of that lecture than my classmates. And as soon as I got home that day, I would review the same lectures that we were taught that day. This process led to me utilizing a system called spaced repetition. Spaced repetition is a system that utilizes increasing intervals of time between subsequent reviews. This video is sponsored by Lecturio. Lecturio is an e-learning platform with thousands of online lectures taught by award-winning educators. Whether you're on the path to attend medical or nursing school, Lecturio has high-quality medical video lectures covering all relevant medical fields with interactive Q-banks to assess learned knowledge. Their on-the-go Lecturio app will allow you to preview relevant content before lecture and review problem areas after lecture. In addition, their spaced repetition quiz allows you to improve your ability to recall information and stay on track with regular notifications for questions that are due. A unique feature of Lecturio is the Book Matcher. This allows you to find relevant video lectures for topics in your medical textbooks such as first aid, Robin's basic pathology, and rapid review. Simply scan the relevant page with your smartphone and you'll be instantly guided to all the relevant videos for your current topic. You can try Lecturio today with 20% off any subscription by using the code DRWEB20. Short-term memory is stored and is retrieved sequentially. Say, for instance, you were given a list of medications to remember in a particular order. Well, you will try to retrieve this list of medications in the exact order that you heard them. Long-term memory is stored and is retrieved by association. This is why when you lose a set of keys or a certain item that you backtrack and go back to the places that you were before. And in medicine, it's all about associations. So whatever particular concept that I'm learning or trying to remember, I always try to come up with some type of association. Say for instance, we're learning about Ewing sarcoma. Well, the translocation for Ewing sarcoma is 11 and 22. And the way I remember that is that Patrick Ewing, who is a famous basketball player who played for the New York Knicks, wore the number 33 on his jersey. So 11 plus 22 is 33. There's also a marker called CD99 that is associated with Ewing sarcoma. And 11 plus 22 is 33. 33 times 3 is 99. Another association that I recently came up with is the ODI score, which is a scoring system in spine surgery. ODI has a letter O in it, and a low ODI score, which is good, has the letter O in it as well. So whatever association that you come up with, this will help you remember things when you're taking exams and going throughout your medical career. So over the years, these are the ways that I memorize things in college, medical school, residency, as well as now in fellowship. I hope you guys learned something from this. Comment in the box below. What are some things or ways that you have memorized things in your medical training? This is Dr. Webb. Thank you for watching this video. Make sure you subscribe. New videos coming every week. We'll see you next time.